Welcome to the Blazor DataGrid tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to connect Microsoft SQL Server data to the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component. There are several ways to bind data to the DataGrid, such as using the data source property or the custom adapter. However, in this video, I will specifically focus on remote data binding with a URL adapter. First, let's see how to bind data from Microsoft SQL Server using an API service. To create the project, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the ASP.NET Core Web App and provide the project name. I am using the .NET 8 as the framework for this project. When I click the Create button, the project creation will begin. Now the application is ready to use. First, I will demonstrate how to create a relational database using SQL Server for storing our data. To interact with the database server, I select the View menu and choosing SQL Server Object Explorer from the drop-down. Now let me create a new database that will store our data. To do this, right-click on the Databases folder and click Add New Database and name it Order Details. This database will store all the order-related information. After creating it, you can see order details appear on the list of databases. Next, I need to add a table to this new database, so expand the order details database. Right-click on the Tables folder and select Add New Table. In the Design window, create a table named Orders, which will store key order details such as order ID, customer ID, employee ID, freight, and ship city. Add these columns with their respective data types. Observe that the orders table is rendered based on the query. Once the table structure is set up, click the Update button to generate a query, then click Update Database to apply the changes. This will ensure that your orders table is created within the database. To verify the table's creation, right-click on the orders table and select View Data. This option allows you to see the table's current state, which is initially empty. Now I'll add some initial data to the orders table. Here, I need to access the data from the order details database. So let me set up a controller that will pull data from the DB context and pass it to the Blazor application. For that, I create a new folder named controller within the project and add a class named grid controller. After creating the Grid Controller class, I'll include the Microsoft ASP.NET Core MVC namespace. Then, let me inherit from Controller Base, which is essential for handling web API requests in ASP.NET Core. Next, to mark the class as a web API controller, I'll add the API controller attribute, which enables automatic model validation and request data binding. The next step is to define a model that represents the data I want to work with. So, inside this class, I create the order model class, which includes several properties that correspond to the columns in the order details database: order ID, customer ID, employee ID, freight, and ship city. Here, I also added the key attribute to the order ID property to mark it as the primary key, which uniquely identifies each order. To store the orders, let me create a static list named orders. Next, I need to add a connection string to interact with the database. To do this, let me open the database location, right-click on the order details database, and select the properties option. Here, you can see the connection string in the database properties window. I will copy the string and close the database properties window. And inside the grid controller class, I declare a connection string variable and paste the copied connection string into it. This string provides the essential information needed to connect the application to the database. Next, to connect to the Microsoft SQL Server database, I need to install the System Data SQL Client NuGet package. To do that, open the NuGet Package Manager, switch to the Browse tab, search for the System Data SQL Client NuGet package, and install it. Then import the System Data SQL Client namespace to use the SQL Connection class for database operations. Next, inside the grid controller class, let me create a public method named getOrderData. This method can be accessed as part of the web API and returns a list of order objects. Then set the route attribute above the getOrderData method and use the template. This placeholder will be replaced by the controller name. For instance, if it's grid controller, the route will be API/grid. Inside the method, I'll define the SQL query string to select all columns from the table and sort the results by order ID. After that, I'll create a new SQL connection object using the connection string. This object will manage the connection to the SQL server. Next, let me open a connection to the database. Then create a new SQL command object using the query string and the open connection. This object will execute the query. Next, using SQL command, create a new SQL data adapter object. The data adapter is used to fill a data table with the query results. Then create a new data table object to hold the data retrieved by the data adapter and fill it with data from the database. After that, close the connection to the database to release database resources. Next, I'll handle each row in the data table. To do this, create a new order object and populate its properties with data from the corresponding columns. The transformed results will be converted into a list and assigned to the data source variable. Then let me return this list of order objects, which will be serialized to JSON and sent as the HTTP response. Next, open the program CS file and register the addCores method, adding cores services to the application. Here, the addPolicy method was defined to create a course policy that allowed requests from any origin with any HTTP method and headers. I'll use the app variable to configure the request pipeline with middleware that allows any origin method, header, and credentials by defining the useCores method. I'll apply the cores policy named cores policy to manage cross-origin requests. Next, let me set up endpoint routing for HTTP requests and establish a default route for MVC controllers using map default controller route to ensure a conventional URL pattern. Now let me run the example application. You can see the default homepage. Now I set the path manually. You can see that the provided record is shown from the grid controller. To automatically navigate to the API endpoint when launching the application, open the launch settings JSON file in the My Web Service project and add the relative URL to open in the browser. Now let me run the example. You'll see the browser automatically navigating to the endpoint. Next, I will show you how to connect Blazor DataGrid to an API service. Here, you can see where I have already added the Blazor web application to the same project. Now, let me open the Home Razor component. I have already added the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component with the grid columns. If you want to learn how to add the Blazor DataGrid component to a Blazor web app, check the video link provided in the YouTube card above. Next, I'll define the Syncfusion Data Manager tag and set the URL property to hold the URL of the RESTful service endpoint from which the grid will fetch data. Now, I will run my web service project alone, so ensure the correct project is selected. Now, let's run the example application. And you can see the provided record is shown from the database. I'll copy the URL and paste it into the URL property, then add the adapter property, set to URL adapter, enabling the data grid to send requests to a specified URL endpoint to fetch, update, delete, or insert data. Before running the example, I'll first display the records in the Blazor data grid component. To achieve this, let me open the grid controller class. Ensure to import the Syncfusion Blazor namespace, which is needed to use the built-in Data Manager Request class. Inside this class, I'll create a POST method to handle incoming data requests. Then, use the FromBody attribute to bind the request data to a parameter. The Data Manager Request parameter is added from the request body. This is a Syncfusion object that contains details like paging, sorting, and filtering for the data grid. If you want to know more on adding paging, sorting, and other data operations, check the video linked in the description below. In the post method, I'll get the data source by calling the getOrderData method, which returns a list of order objects for the data grid. I'll then calculate the total number of records. Next, return an object with two properties, result and count. Then add HTTP post and route attributes to specify that this method handles post requests. Now that the setup is complete, I'll configure the application to run multiple projects simultaneously. So, click the drop-down arrow next to the Run button and select and configure startup projects. Here, enable multiple startup projects and set the start action for both the server and the web service projects. With the startup projects set to multiple, I'll run the example application. Once the application starts, notice that both projects run simultaneously, and the data grid component is rendered with the data retrieved from the database. Next, I'll show you how to perform CRUD operations using URL adapter. Let's proceed to see about the insert, update, and delete operations. To start with the insert operation, inside the grid controller class, I create an insert method with the required code logic to bind incoming data to the grid. The method is triggered by an HTTP post request at the specified API endpoint. This SQL query inserts a new record into the orders table, executes it, and then closes the connection. Next, navigate to the Home Razor component. Define the Grid Edit Settings tag and set the Allow Adding property to True. Then I add the Toolbar property to display options like Add, Edit, Delete, Cancel, and Update. Then add the Insert URL property in the Syncfusion Data Manager tag and set it to the Insert URL. Look now, you'll see the data grid rendered with the toolbar. When I click the Add button, fill in all fields, and then click Update, the record is successfully updated. Also, check the database and refresh it. You'll see the new record inserted successfully. Next, I'll show you how to perform an update operation. In the Grid Controller class, I create an update method with the necessary code logic to bind incoming data to the grid. It builds a SQL query to update an existing record in the orders table using the order ID. After executing the query, the connection is closed to release resources. Next, navigate to the Home Razor component and set the Allow Editing property to True. Add the Update URL property and set it to the Update URL. Before running the example, I set the isPrimaryKey property to true for the order ID column because the update method is designed to update an existing record in the orders table based on the order ID. Looking here, select a record and click the Edit button, edit the ship city, and click the Update button. Notice that the edited record is updated successfully. Also, refresh the database, and you will see the edited record updated. Next, I'll show you how to perform a delete operation. In the Grid Controller class, I create a delete method with necessary code logic to bind incoming data to the grid. The method builds a SQL query to delete a record from the orders table using the order ID. After executing the query, the connection is closed to release resources. Navigate to the Home Razor component and set the Allow Deleting property to True. Add the Remove URL property and set it to the Delete URL. Look now, select a record and click the Delete button. Notice that the selected record is deleted successfully. Refresh the database and you will see the selected record deleted. If you want to know more about CRUD operations in detail, Check the documentation link provided in the description below. Now let me summarize. I showed you how to connect Microsoft SQL Server data to the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component, and demonstrated how to perform CRUD operations. If you want to see the working code for this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can check if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor components. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.